You're watching Liquid Lunch on Newsmax TV. I'm Frank Moreno. You know what? I don't know what it is about New York, but for whatever reason, like the song says, if you can make it here, you really can make it anywhere. And there are so many great New York characters over the years that have found their way into world domination of whatever field they're in. You want to talk politics? You have to look at Chuck Schumer, Gerald Nadler, and Donald Trump, a few New Yorkers. You want to talk entertainment? You talk about guys like Humphrey Bogart and James Cagney. You want to talk the military, you talk about guys like Colin Powell. You want to talk about the talk show game, you got guys like Regis Philbin and Larry King. Whatever the case is, New York has the most interesting characters in the world. Here's one of them.
My name is Wayne Diamond. I'm coming back, baby. I like, you know, when I walk around New York City, here's Wayne Diamond, the legend. Greatest, most incredible guy that ever lived. He's the most famous guy in the dress business of all times. And I guess I was at the time, you know, for about 30 years.
Who was the best of all time? Tell them.
They don't know.
Legend.
The greatest dress designer and dress seller that ever lived. 90% of the dresses are being sold today, I put together.
That's the famous Wayne Diamond.
Everything starts in a barbershop. You know, this is where it starts. In the old days, is the way we used to be in a garment center. Everybody would have their hair blown out, their nails done, everything done right, polishing the whole bit, you know? You gotta look good.
Make sure you get those hairs out of my nose. I never had hair growing on my nose, all of a sudden out of nowhere.
That iconic New York character is now being discovered by audiences around the country and the world. That man with that George Hamilton-style tan is the one and only Wayne Diamond. Wayne, welcome. Thanks so much for coming in.
So nice to see you, Frank.
It's great to see you.
Now, great to see you.
You are a legend in the garment center and the garment business. You're one of those guys that a lot of people thought was just famous for being famous, but you actually got your start in the garment business not through years of study, but through an encounter with the famous mobster Meyer Lansky. Tell us what happened.
I would call him a mobster. I mean, Meyer Lansky was an incredible guy. This guy built Israel all on his own. You know, he supported it in 47 and 48, and he also supported it in 67. He put up the money. Just a fabulous guy. I met him on 48th Street Beach in Miami. And as I came down there in a bus, I had no money in those days, so I took a Greyhound bus down to Miami, and I signed his name at the Eden Rock. And before you know it, he came over to me, 5'1". I mean, who knew? I was a Jew from Long Island. What the freak do I know? He said, you know, he asked me a lot of questions and things, and he told me to get back to him. And I did 4 years later, 5 years later, he put me into the dress business. Great guy.
But for a while, you're going to say he put you in a dress.
No, hey, listen, I mean, you know, whatever it takes. I mean, RuPaul did it. Why should I?
All right, so now the rumor about you is, so you were in the garment business for a few decades before deciding to step away. I had heard that you earned over $100 million in the garment business. Is that accurate?
Hey, look, I mean, I was in the business for 35 years. If I didn't earn close to $100 million or more than $100 million, it really doesn't matter. I'm sure I earned a lot more than $100 million.
You lost some of that money, too.
Yeah, absolutely. Dealing with that Wall Street crap that put this guy in as our president by creating a mess in America. That's what I did, you know.
So on the stock, in the stock market,
stock
market.
I don't want to even talk.
Okay, fine.
Stock market is not for me.
So now, audiences all over the country are discovering the phenom that is Wayne Diamond through the film Uncut Gems. Now, this is a film that's been critically acclaimed. A lot of people were talking about either the film itself or Adam Sandler for an Academy Award nomination. Ultimately, the Academy snubbed the film. How do you feel about being passed over by the Academy?
It's not me. It's the Safdie brothers. It's Sebastian McLeod. It's all of them. These people work their tushes off. I got this piece of paper. I can't say too many words that are, you know, I mean, they work their bitch, slutty, Jesus asses off.
So those are all acceptable.
They're
right?
All acceptable,
okay,
words. No,
thank
I'm reading
you.
The acceptable column here, right?
Thank you.
I want to make sure.
I mean,
God, you know, please.
And Newsmax appreciates
God's
it.
Sakes, God's
thank
sakes,
you.
For God's sakes.
Yeah.
You know, these are all great guys. Everybody in that movie was incredible. They worked hard. They worked 24 hours a day. I mean, I'm an older guy. I never saw guys work this. And they're smart. They're smart. And They put together this movie, and not to get any credit for all the work they put into it, the time, and Bronstein, Ronnie, who wrote it.
So
incredible, incredible move. Diamond dealer, you know, a guy that sells diamonds on 47th Street. And Adam knew a lot about it. You know, he studied it. He went through all this work, going through the whole thing, got thrown through a window. I mean, you know, he was a gambler, degenerate gambler. I was a degenerate gambler in my day. I stopped. This guy was sick. He was sick. And the movie is about a sick gambler that really, his whole life revolves around one thing, gambling. And how we, what?
I can relate, trust me.
Believe me, I can't do. And we had that crazy guy in there, the announcer guy.
Mike Francesa,
oh,
right?
Oh my God. Okay.
The movie's definitely worth seeing from what you're saying.
Greatest, I tell you, the movie is sensational. I saw it four times. I wasn't disappointed. Each time I saw something different within the movie. It was terrific.
Well, you're not exactly an objective critic. I mean,
absolutely not.
You're in the movie. If you're not saying it's good,
but I'm Frank. I'm a New Yorker. I know what goes on in New York. You know what I mean?
So, do you think the Academy, the reason the movie was snubbed was because of politics? Do you think it wasn't an Academy type of movie? What's the real reason here?
I think that it's the first.
You think it's racism because of your skin pigmentation?
Look at you. You're so goddamn white. I mean, I know, let me look at a list. It's okay. Goddamn is okay, guys.
We think
it's just so goddamn white. No, I don't think it's racism. I think that Adam's first role as a real serious actor, the guy was fabulous. He was better than anybody out there other than, you know, along with the Joker. Another great film.
We got to run, but I want to ask you, I know you're not a fan of your fellow orange man in the White House right now.
I can't stand him. I can't even look at him.
But on the Democratic side of things, who do you like if you had to pick somebody today?
I mean, we all know who could win. Who's the one that could win?
Tell me.
Biden. Biden's the only guy. I mean, we need a guy, you know, to go against Trump, you need a guy like Biden that people respect. They know what he's done. He was with Barack Obama, who was the greatest president that ever lived. And I think it's a choice that we have to make, and he'll take somebody young with him. I pray to God, and things will be good.
Wayne, best of luck with the movie. Thanks for coming in.
Frank, a pleasure, man.
All right, we're going to be right back with Richard Wright, the president and CEO of the Alkaline Water Company. Or if he's not here, we'll be back with somebody else equally interesting, and hopefully that is equally stocked with water. In any event, we'll be right back here on Liquid Lunch on Newsmax TV.
Thank you.